Go to the white phone. Yeah. Internet freedom under attack. What do we do?
Fight back.
Fight back. Okay. What else is under attack?
Food and water under attack. What do we do?
Stand up. Fight back.
What do we do?
Stand up. Fight back.
What do we do?
Stand up. Fight back.
We're not going to take it anymore.
People like us, our country, happy with the results of the study
are favorable. I don't know if I would wipe my nose with that toilet paper. I found that on the floor in a dirty restaurant. In case you didn't know, the province of Quebec, has a moratorium on fracking, and they are being sued by a company in Calgary because this is a constraint of quote unquote trade.
Woo. And we'll see more of that if TTP comes in.
The TPP is a very complicated, very sophisticated piece of proposed legislation. It's going to be passed up and down, over and out, and let's hope it's down. And the reason for that is it won't mobilize enough of issues-oriented people. So be aware and be prepared. This is going to go on and on and on. And if it goes fast, that means that we are up for you know what.
Add it back to Gloria. Gloria's a granny.
Yeah, actually, you said that it's going to affect us and that it's affecting Quebec. It's already affected California. Remember MTBE? We wanted to get rid of MTBE, and we did. And we were sued by the Canadian corporation that produces MTBE. And although we got rid of it in California, we had to pay a huge fine to that corporation for their loss of profit. This is the way it's going to be. And that was just under an apple.
Okay. All right. We're coming in. We're going to try to out. The rally will now begin. First song, Granny, just went to Memphis, okay? Okay. And then I'm going to turn it over to Carlene, who's running this show.
Thank you so much. We celebrate so many of our brothers and sisters here from all over and all different sectors. So we've been able to so does the TPP sound like something we want to rush through Congress?
No!
Well, as we've heard, there's something called Fast Track sitting in front of Congress right now. It's a bill that would force our representatives to vote yes or vote no on so-called plea deals like the TPP. So no debate and no discussion. Is that the kind of democracy that we want?
No!
So, 20 years ago, when the NAFTA started, the symbol of this free trade agreement was the butterfly, the monarch butterfly. Do you remember?
Yeah.
And one of the principles of the NAFTA was the defense of the environment. So, 20 years after, this year is the worst year for monarch butterfly. From the past year, this year, we have lost 46% of the butterflies only from in 1 year. We have only like 1.7 hectares, like maybe 4 acres of trees where they are coming to hibernate. So it's totally insane what they are doing now with the what's called the Republic Project. And it's crazy that a lot of people don't pay attention to what's going on now. I think we have to create a momentum so we can bring millions of people to the street. When we think about the march against Monsanto, how many people came out? Millions of people. And to Monsanto, who's behind all this stuff, PepsiCo, Walmart, Costco, all these 6 or 7 corporations that are controlling all the brands in our grocery stores. So we have to start talking with the different sectors that are very, very upset against all these corporations, and we have to ask them to join us. We have to create different campaigns, your own campaigns with your working family members, with friends, with everyone in your neighborhood. You have to start your own campaign in order to bring more people to the next action. So just so you to know, in Mexico, 20 years ago, we had a woman 34% of obesity. Now we have 74%. So we have a lot of more cases. Everything has all the diseases related to diabetes or high pressure. Has an increase in an exponential way. So it's very, very dangerous what's going on in Mexico. People are eating a lot more junk food. In Mexico now we have a class action lawsuit against the GMO crops that the government in Monsanto have been trying to start growing in Mexico. But if they approve the TPP, it's going to be very dangerous for the 700 varieties of corn that we have in Mexico. And these 700 varieties of corn that we have in Mexico represent 700 different meals that the Mexicans cook every day. In Mexico, we need different kind of food for different kind of meals. If we lose our corn, we lose our gastronomy also. So that is the difference between India and Mexico. In India, they lost all their cotton seeds, but was used for textile. In Mexico, we are defending our corn because it's our food, and it's our tradition, it's our part of our culture. So I invite you to work in solidarity with Mexico, working against the TPP, you know, because it's about everything. This is about all the different corporations behind this Chevron, behind this Monsanto, all these corporations that have been affecting the environment in the last 20 years. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope to see you again. Tomorrow we have an action of 24 emissions from 3 p.m. until all the afternoon. If you want to come and speak, we're going to open the microphone. We want to talk about GMOs, but I would like you to come and talk about the TPP. Thank you so much.
I'm the Northern California organizer with Food and Water Watch. We're an advocacy watchdog organization out there every day to protect our food and water resources. The CDC is trouble for our food, our water, and our environment. And even though we can't see it, big oil, big gas, and big country, multinational corporations are right here. Will equal less local food, more fracking, sketchy seafood imports, no GMO labeling, and more corporate control of our democracy. We're going to get a little bit of pressure on fracking. Food and Water Watch, along with our allies across California, across the nation, are fighting for a ban on fracking. But it is going to open large markets of export of liquefied natural gas, largely to Japan. Japan is the largest importer of natural gas. So that means definitely more push to frack America, to frack California. Second, and probably more frightening, and this is what we found out most, is the provision of the CPD that would allow foreign and multinational governments to sue our cities and our state governments that pass local legislation against fracking. So right now, I'm working with communities in Butte County, in San Bernardino County, in Los Angeles, and they're working to protect their homes from this big industrial oil and gas operation. And what would happen is that these multinational corporations, they could sue based on trade barriers, and that wouldn't be determined in court. It would be determined in international trade tribunals. Just quickly, some of the other TPP issues. The gals have talked a ton about GMO labeling. This deal would allow importers of food to force products suspected of border inspections to be tainted into our commerce while testing is being carried out. It would increase imports of unsafe farm-raised seafood, like provinces like Vietnam, and it would do nothing to increase our labor and our environmental standards in the country. So how do we stop the CPPO? Earlier this month, we know Fast Track was introduced. We have to stop Fast Track. So we need everyone calling their representatives, being out here today in the streets of the streets. Thank you, everyone, for being out here. Please get on the phone, call your representative, go into Pelosi's office, tell her to vote no on Fast Track and oppose the CPPO for the good of our food, our water, and our environment. Thank you, everybody.
Oh my God. You're pulling a couple of holes in it. He won't blow away.
When people say